in order to be certified, you must be verified by someone who is qualified. I'm going to say that again, Brother Si. In order to be certified, you must be verified by someone who is qualified.
If we were to do a comparative study of monotheistic religions today in retrospect to ancient civilizations, we'd be able to definitively conclude that just about all these people with all their different ideological beliefs and constructs were encountered by relatively the same beings. And they interpreted their encounters with these beings based on the best level of understanding that they had at that particular day and time. But if we were to do a comparative study of all these religions, we would come to find that globally, they were encountered by the similar or the same species.
You have people that are in the community who say they are upset with the Amun-Ra Squad because we believe in modern, we believe in evolution, and we agree with modern science. Now, they need to understand that mathematics and science is African spirituality, because what our ancestors did was study nature, and science is just a systematic study of the physical and natural world. That's what science is, and mathematics is the language of science. It's the language of nature. So when you study mathematics and study science, you are practicing African spirituality. So for people who say that they don't study math, or that's the white man's science, or that's the white man's math, we gave science and mathematics to the world.
How come the pyramids that all the conscious community people
take credit for,
that they built according to celestial prototype? You can't deny that. How can you line up the three pyramids of Giza with the Orion star concept? How is that? Why is that?
They may say someone was taken by a cloud. Well, that may have been relative speech or jargon for that day and time. But in this day and time, the religions need an upgrade. So a cloud would have to be a ship. But in that day and time, they would express what they bear witness to based on their level of understanding.
So Brother Si, today I'm trying to really put an end to the foolery that aliens built the pyramids. Of course, New Age science will say that aliens came down and gave them, these people, you know, the knowledge to build these monuments, or that aliens came down and picked up the 2-ton blocks for them, and that they didn't have the sophistication to build these monuments or to align them with the stars. Our ancestors did have the knowledge to or the ability to align the pyramids with whatever they wanted to align it with. They did have the knowledge or the ability to move 2-ton blocks because they understood math and they understood physics. And that's all it took: physics, math, and astronomical science and observation in order to align the pyramids.
Some of these doctrines were tailor-made for a specific species,
right?
So only they will respond to this information.
Well, I'm going to contend first and foremost that which you call the melanated species on this planet, because I have a priority interest in them in this particular moment, that they have spiritual parents. When I say spiritual, I don't mean spooky spiritual. I'm saying that what you call extraterrestrials is not simply limited to the physical shell.
When you say extraterrestrial, let's break down what extraterrestrial
is.
Because sometimes you can have a spooky outlook if you understand only semantics and not understanding the understanding behind what it means.
Well, what it means?
What is a terrestrial is something that exists on the planet. You're a terrestrial. An extraterrestrial meaning something that is not native to this plane of existence called Earth that is here now.
I'm extraterrestrial.
Extraterrestrial means something extra that is not here, that is not naturally from here. There's a lot of that here.
I will contend that just about all these different religions primarily have the same source, which is the extraterrestrial experience. They were all having a hard time trying to explain what they encountered.
are you also talking about a creature, a living creature that's on this planet that don't look like us?
Yes. Why not? When I stand up and talk about extraterrestrials and their influence and their intervention and the creation of man, I represent the whole community at that time.
Whether they like it or not, I'm your representative. You should have voted someone else in my place, but I'm here today.
So, when I talk about the extraterrestrial experience, I can give you a whole lot more information than your average black power brother or sister that just uses the whole continent. You understand what I'm saying?
Now we get into some spooky shit.
Oh no, it's not spooky. Why is it spooky? Now I'm gonna explain this.
Yeah.
I'm explaining this. You know what's spooky?
What?
Where we all say, I'm from Africa, right? This is what we do in the black continent. I'm from Africa, right? This is what we say all the time. Then when you ask what part of Africa, everybody go blank. You see what I'm saying? That shit's spooky. Extraterrestrial doesn't necessarily have to be an entity. Okay, a human or a human-like entity or biological entity. An extraterrestrial can be a meteorite, okay? It's an asteroid outside of the planet and becomes a meteor inside of the planet. When it comes into the planet, by definition, scientifically speaking, anything that comes from outside the planet that comes into the confines of this planet is extraterrestrial. You're from a whole continent, but if I ask you what part geographically, you go blank. Gonna say is the spooky part is claiming a whole continent but not identifying with a specific culture that is found within the confines of that particular continent. That's spooky. That's the reason why people don't want to speak about extraterrestrials, because it's scary. All these religions primarily were encountered by these sentient beings that visited this planet, and they all have it on record. So it's why it's so hard for the people who subscribe to the Egyptian community to subscribe to the concept of extraterrestrials.
So how are you trying to tell me that
do I believe in V, and do I believe in people with
lizard tongues
coming out
built by the extraterrestrials?
You see, if you get into the extraterrestrial doctrine, you'll start engaging in higher understanding, and then you'll really understand why religion is such a divisive tool to keep the masses fighting and causing great dissension amongst humanity. You'll understand that this works to the benefit of an elite group of contrivances that's on this planet.
And this is where archaeologists have found the oldest evidence of symbolic thought. Not only did they find the oldest evidence of symbolic thought, but they also found the oldest evidence of a mathematical thought, which corroborates my claim that these ideas were born in South Africa, and they reached Central Africa first, and eventually culminated in Kemet, allowing our ancestors to build the great structures like the pyramids and the Sphinx.
In fear that people actually wake up and bear witness to these truths, we'll be able to get out of the situation we're in. We are the offspring of that which they call God, which in truth is what we would say today is an extraterrestrial. How could they have done this? And we seen they recorded everything on the walls, but we can't find the technology where they was able to do these things. You can be impressed by a higher consciousness that is not limited to the physical ship.
You run a faggot operation, you're a piece of shit. You are a demon against black people. You work for the CIA and the National Security Agency with your wicked smiles. And I'm not being polite about it. How in the fuck are you a young phenom? You're a piece of shit. And that's an insult to every piece of shit that ever was shitted on the planet. How in the fuck are you gonna say that the white man is the devil?
You over here, nigga. You over here. I ain't polite, yo.
Well, I ain't polite too.
I ain't polite.
Come over here.
Leave that nigga alone.
And tell me don't start no shit.
Polite.
Bitch ass nigga. All of you a bitch ass.
Bitch ass nigga. All of you a bitch ass.
If your children couldn't get themselves together to get themselves out of a situation that they potentially put themselves in, why should your parents come and aid you? You see what I'm saying? They should step back and see when you are truly waiting for the help by showing what you would do for and amongst each other. So when we look at this situation and say, how come? This isn't relevant to all people that even look dark skinned, to tell you the truth.
That's right.
And when we talking about our liberation and our movement and our uprising,
That's not for everybody. Some people that look dark skinned are meant to be these slaves from now to the rest of their life into another generation. They are not chosen people.
And when I say chosen, not in a spooky way, I'm saying that each group of people, each race, each species has something or someone that they adhere to.
It's no spookery, you know, as to how they built the pyramids, how they maneuvered granular structures, how they aligned things with the true north or aligned them with whatever star they were targeting. It's no spookism. You know, it wasn't an alien that did it. They had a system. You know, they had a methodology as to how they did things, and they implemented it. And that's what allowed them to maneuver granular structures, to align things with the true north, to produce mathematical papyri. So I just want our brothers and sisters to be armed with this information when someone approaches them and say, oh no, the aliens did it, or no, the Arabs did it, or the Hebrews did it. I want our brothers and sisters to say, no, that we know exactly how they built the pyramids. We know exactly how they were aligned, and we know exactly how they moved these granular structures.
Extraterrestrials, it is my personal conviction that extraterrestrials have played more than an exponential role in the creation of human beings, point blank period. It is also my personal conviction that extraterrestrials played more than an exponential role in giving us information to build our ancient civilizations. It is also my personal conviction that these same extraterrestrials and some new additions are still participating in society today. It is my conviction that they have interceded when human beings was about to completely destroy this whole planet. Y'all understand that this works to the benefit of an elite group of contrivances that's on this planet that make an expense at the hell of everybody else's plagues. That's why nobody wants us to get to the extraterrestrial reality. It is better off to study something you can't relate to or engage. Extraterrestrials. I would break the word up into extraterrestrial, but I'm always gonna go to the dictionary first. But it's in the word, extra, additional amount, terra being earth in Latin, and astral from the stars, something additional from the stars on planet Earth. We can go into the dictionary, we can look for something, we'll find something relatively similar to that definition or to that explanation. So there's no hint to what we're talking about. Something that is influencing us on planet Earth that comes from the stars. The white man is taking the racism to the stars, because he knows by the time we realize who our gods are, who our deities are, by the time we realize who are the heavenly hosts and what it means represents to this extraterrestrial doctrine, he would have already imposed himself and made himself the extraterrestrial as we're coming into a new paradigm and people are waking up and realizing religion doesn't have all the answers. Now, you will find the ifs, the maybes, the probablys from him when the questions are posed. How did we build those pyramids? When I go into the specifics of what it takes to build a pyramid, what kind of technology, what we must do with granite, what we must do with lodestone, the fact that it's piezoelectric, and why would it have to be piezoelectric, meaning when you compress something in an intense fashion, one of several things is going to take place, okay? One is that you're going to establish levity.
That's a lie. So I'm getting ready to get into the building methods of Kemet and how they actually moved these 2-ton blocks or these 10-ton blocks.
So I'm going to be interested to see how would he possibly debunk the possibility or the actualities that correspond with the influence of beings of supernatural and superior elements that exist outside the context of this particular planet Earth.
So, the mathematical foundations of the structures attest that its creators had a working knowledge of algebra, geometry, trigonometry, astronomical science, because they aligned these monuments with celestial bodies, mechanics, material science, and physics. Now, I'm getting ready to touch on the mechanics, material science, and physics, because they had to understand mechanics, material science, and physics in order to create a ramp system that would maneuver these 2-ton blocks.
The extraterrestrials are responsible for our creation. extraterrestrials have educated mankind, and extraterrestrials are responsible.
But that's a lie, family. So now I'm getting ready to get into the building methods of Kemet and how they actually, how do they build these structures? Because again, Brother Si, there's a lot of misinformation out there regarding this. People say that the aliens did it, that they weren't equipped to move two ton blocks.
When you talk about the extraterrestrials, are you saying that I want you to describe these things that you're talking about? No, I mean, what do you mean by extraterrestrials? How do they look? Or what
they can look like rocks. Because a rock can be extraterrestrial.
So rocks build the pyramids, you're saying?
They use rocks to build pyramids. I'm gonna go specifically.
Yes.
So this is giving archaeologists and scientists an idea as to how they maneuvered heavy materials. This paper is written in the physical review letters entitled "Sliding Friction on Wet and Dry Sand."
I'm going to show you that it is evident that beings of higher intelligence from other planets have in some cases imposed their will on the human race and in other cases shared information. And I know this is I'm putting myself out there.
But in it, Brother Si, and this is what's getting ready to kill you. In this paper, it states they did an excavation on a pyramid from 1900 BCE. And guess what they found, Brother Si, on the pyramid? The names of the pyramid builders written in red ochre. So they found the names of the pyramid builders. So we can't say, Brother Si, anymore that the aliens came to build the pyramids. Because if the aliens came to build the pyramids, would they have put their names in red ochre?
Describe it.
Yeah.
They look like me.
Okay.
Some of them. They look just like me. I'm extraterrestrial. That's going to be a difficult thing to disprove.
And what these authors did, this is a very, very powerful paper. Anyone who is interested in understanding how the Egyptians moved these two-ton blocks should get this paper. It's again published in the Physical Review Letters. The publication date is May the 2nd, 2014. And the title is Sliding Friction on Wet and Dry Sand. So what they did, what these physicists did, was investigate the effect of different amounts of water on the sliding friction of a variety of sands by measuring the force necessary to pull the sled.
It's almost stifling intellectually to even conceptualize how someone like himself could not even take into consideration extraterrestrial intervention. As I divulge into the ancient Egyptian text, as I divulge into the ancient Egyptian doctrine, I would believe that text is super saturated with extraterrestrial intervention.
So they were pouring water. The assertion is this, Brother Si, is that they were pouring water onto the sand to decrease the friction, which would allow them to pull a sled that was weighted down by a statue or a block.
If something comes from outside the planet and into the planet and offsets a chain reaction of life, it has been life then must be influenced by that which is extraterrestrial. This is also true.
Okay, so what they did in this paper was this. They computed what's called a friction coefficient. A friction coefficient, what is friction? Friction is resistance. So they computed what's called a friction coefficient, and they computed something called a shear modulus. A shear modulus is a coefficient that measures the stiffness of a material. Okay, and what they saw was this, that the friction coefficient and the shear modulus are inversely proportional. And I'm getting ready to explain what the friction and the shear modulus is. So this is what, so in layman's terms, Brother Si, when you pour water onto the sand, capillary bridges, okay, liquid membranes created between two bodies. So when you pour water onto the sand, capillary bridges form. And when these capillary bridges form, that increases the shear modulus. When that increases the shear modulus, that decreases the friction, allowing you to pull something that's heavy.
We found a lot of information. You find a lot of stuff about medicine and honey from the Egyptians and everything. They left things on the wall. But we didn't get the information on how the hell did you see those planets. We didn't find the technology that you left over either, but you left us amazing technology. We trying to figure out what did you use to build it. I'm going to dig a lot deeper, and I'm going to show you. And my persuasion will be empirical data.
So they had gangs, and that's what I want to explain to the people. There were gangs that they formed in order to move these limestone blocks. There were gangs. They worked in gangs to do this, and each gang actually wrote their name in red ochre on the pyramid blocks. So what am I saying to you, family? You can't tell me that the aliens did it, because where did red ochre come from? Where did that tradition come from? The tradition of writing things in red ochre, body painting yourself in red ochre and on your body, brother Sai, that's an African tradition. That came right out of Africa. So, I mean, unless the aliens came from Africa or South Africa, you know, it wasn't aliens that built the pyramids.
What I would suggest we talk about in this particular case, I'll give you one facet of a multifaceted answer, because once we say creation, we can say how human beings interface and create, because that's magical in itself. And when I say magical, I'm talking in the realm of science. It's magical in itself how two human beings could create a child seemingly from nowhere. But of course, we're talking about high intelligence as relates to man possibly being influenced or even modified, genetically modified, or even being educated.
Anybody else?
It would have to be no thing before it comes something. And when I say some, I don't mean S-O-M-E. I say, like Dr. York told us, S-U-M.
But when you say no thing, what do you mean? No thing, what do you mean?
I mean the subatomic realm versus the elemental. Generally, there's an insecurity imposed upon us by blacks because of post-slavery traumatic disorder, that we have a tendency to claim identity to things that may not necessarily be associated with us, because we're still in search of an identity, so we tend to kidnap other identities. We're becoming like the mind of the colonizer that imposes will on us. So, it makes many of us feel insecure to accredit some of the world's greatest phenomena, such as pyramids, to accredit the construction of pyramidal structures of this planet Earth to an extraterrestrial is almost like denying and depriving the black race of a great accomplishment.
What you're looking at right here is a wall painting in the ancient tomb of Jehudi-Hotep, which is dated to 1900 BCE. All right? So this right here is an actual facsimile of the wall painting. But let me give you a better view. So this is a cleaned up view of what you're looking at. This is a cleaned up view. And what it shows, it depicts 172 men hauling an immersed statue using ropes attached to a sledge. In the drawing, you can see a person. Brother Sai, look at this right here, okay? So you have 172 men hauling a statue on a sled. And you have these men hauling it while this person is pouring something on the sand. You see that? Now this picture was in a tomb, 1900 BCE.
And as I said, it may not speak to an insecurity that he has, but it most definitely speaks to an insecurity that most pro-black conscious people have.
Talking about
extraterrestrials.
So this is, I want to direct your attention to this article called The Coast in Color. This article is describing Pinnacle Point. Pinnacle Point is located right here, south of Mazel Bay, near the Indian Ocean. So you're at the bottom of Africa, okay? Pinnacle Point was a cave that was occupied at the earliest 164,000 years ago. All right. So it was occupied in 165,000 years ago. It was occupied again 140,000 years ago. And then it was continuously occupied from 120,000 years to 90,000 years ago. And they found, you know, shellfish remains, a red pigment, and stone bladelets. But this is the most important find right here, Brother Sai. They found 57 pieces of hematite, which is an iron ore that can be ground up to produce a blood red pigment called red ochre. So red ochre came out of the south, and the pyramid builders wrote their names in red ochre on the pyramid blocks. So if we had this information, see, Brother Sai, that's why it's important to study. If you understood that they, if you knew that they wrote their names in red ochre, and you understood that this tradition came from South Africa.
I'm sorry, but I gotta do this, man. This shit here is real scholarship right here, my. A lot of people ain't ready for this right here, what you showing. You know what I'm saying? Because I think you are going over a lot of people's heads right now. Only the advanced students is ready for this, like the Amon Ra Squad. And there's a lot of smart people out there too. But I'm saying this work right here, what you putting in, this is not for the religious minds. They looking at you like, man, this girl is out of her damn mind. Where'd she get this from? But I'm looking at this like you proving everything that you're showing up here right now. This is real scholarship.